and welcome to today's edition of Frightfully Forgotten. And what are we drinking today, my dear friend?
We're drinking Shockwaves, a German Roggen beer.
Today we're going to be talking about 1986's Night of the Creeps. We were requested to do it by our friend Ron Moore, who was kind enough to have us on his podcast called The Manitoba Money Shot.
Yeah. The Money Shot is not what you think.
Yeah. There'll be a link to the podcast in the description below. It is written and directed by Fred Dekker. He also did Monster Squad. It stars Jason Lively, and he, of course, is in European Vacation. He plays
Rusty.
Rusty, yeah. One of the many Rusties.
Mm-hmm.
And aside him is the living legend, the B-movie master,
yep,
Tom Atkins.
The movie starts out completely out of left field with these little aliens, and they're shooting at this one alien who's holding this great big canister. He shoots this canister out of the hold of the ship, and it floats towards Earth. It's 1959. While they're driving to this lover's lane, on the radio they hear that there's an escaped mental patient, so he's on the loose. He's still on the loose! There's a cop that's kind of patrolling this lover's lane, and he comes up to this couple and he tells them to get moving, right? Because this guy's on the loose.
He's on the loose!
Fireball comes through the sky. He goes searching for it, and he finds this canister that's been driven into the ground. While he's looking at this canister, the woman sitting in the car, there's the mental patient behind her. It fast forwards to the 80s. Party night at university or college. One main character, the one that Jason Lively plays, he's Chris. And he's got the hots for this one chick. She belongs to a fraternity. He wants to join this fraternity. Preppy, like,
asshole jock guys.
Yeah, these fraternity guys cook up this scheme. They have to go steal a corpse
and leave it on the front step of the other
fraternities.
Dorms,
yeah. So while they're trying to find this corpse, they uncover this cryogenic room or whatever. Yes. With all these, like, computer consoles.
Yeah.
And there's this one solid tube with this guy in it. Press a bunch of buttons and stuff and release him. Scares the shit out of him, and they take off. This one guy, who's in City Slickers 2, he stumbles upon this corpse that had been thawed now, and he gets it too. Thrill me.
So Ray Cameron gets to the scene. Cameron's confused. He was told there's two corpses. Where's the second corpse? And no one can really answer him. We find out that Cameron is actually the cop from the flashback. In the meantime, this corpse, which is missing from the crime scene, is on the loose.
Still on the loose!
And shows up at the fraternity where the girls are staying. The head explodes.
Yeah.
And these leeches come out, takes over a different body. The creeps,
yeah,
as we'll call them. Cynthia sees this happen. His head exploded and these things came out and they're zombies. Okay.
Yeah. Maybe I better take you home.
And it's funny that the fact that when he finally gets the girl he loves, she sounds like a complete nutcase.
Yeah.
In the meantime, JC has gone by himself to take a shit. One of the infected comes in, screaming like a banshee.
Yeah.
And it's a great scene because he's got nowhere to go. Chris gets back to his dorm and JC's nowhere to be found. But he finds a tape machine, plays it back, and it's basically JC saying he's been infected. Doesn't have much longer to live, but he found out a way to kill him. So now Tom Atkins, Mr. Cameron, and Chris are out to go get the creeps. And who has the guns? The same guys in Terminator.
Yeah.
Rest in peace, Dick Miller.
That's a good gun.
Cameron and Chris show up at the dorm. Ladies, good news and bad news. Good news is, your dates are here. Bad news is, they're dead. And that's where we're going to end it, with Tom Atkins defending and warding off a bunch of zombie-ridden creep corpses. So if you want to see how it ends, watch Night of the Creeps. If you haven't seen it, it's an 80s B-movie camp classic.
Yeah, masterpiece. One of the best things about this movie is the camp.
Yeah.
It starts off from the get-go.
If it didn't have that scene with the aliens in the beginning, you'd take this movie a lot more serious.
Yeah, exactly.
But because it starts off with the scene with the aliens, you're like, this is camp, it's silly. then you're prepared for the rest and knows what it is.
And it purposely went out to be that, too. The dialogue and everything plays into that. Like, the movie was written very well.
The flow is quite good in this movie. The opening black and white flashback scene is done so well.
Yeah, it pays a lot of homage to the old movies from the 50s. A lot of the names, a lot of the last names are paying homage to, like, directors.
Romero, Carpenter.
Yeah, Cronenberg, right?
Totally a love letter to sci-fi and horror movies.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a difference between a ripoff and an homage.
Yeah.
And this is so blatantly an homage and not a ripoff, because in a way, it's very original.
A huge budget for this, too. $5 million.
Which it didn't make back.
No, not... It was like a tenth that it made back. It's so visually pleasing, and it's very colorful. Everything, all the effects in this movie are top-notch. Like, literally top-notch.
Speaking of the effects, it's kind of neat where it's one of the few movies where the whole effects crew is in the movie. The busload of asshole guys, that's the effects crew. And they're all play their own zombies.
Yeah, it's Night of the Creeps, slugs and shit.
Yeah.
But it's also Night of the, like, the creeps. These guys are creeps.
These creepy dudes.
Yeah.
With their shitty 80s mustaches and everything.
Then they look like a bunch of douchebags. Yeah. Tom Atkins.
This could be his best performance. Depth to it, and he has that one speech reliving the whole scenario that happened back in the 50s, back to Chris. And it is actually, I think, Tom Atkins' best performance, that retelling.
And he really is haunted by it.
That's exactly what this movie is about for him, is the past coming back to haunt you and having to get past that. Fun as hell. If you want a good, just 80s party movie, if you like Night of the Comet,
Return of the Living Dead,
right up the alley for you. You gotta watch Night of the Creeps. It doesn't look like a B-movie, but it pretends to be a B-movie.
Yeah, that's the magic of it.
Yeah. One of the best 80s horror comedies of all time.
Yep.
Keep drinking.